If we please can take our seats. Calling this meetings, this evening's meeting to order. We're going to have the invocation by Pastor Terrence M. Curtis of Calvary Baptist Church in Jonesboro. It will be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance. If you would, please stand with me.
Let us pray. God, our Father, we are so grateful for your guidance and your protection that allows us to be here tonight. In a very personal way, oh God, we thank you for commissioning us, Sonia Gregory, who's present. We thank you for your blessings upon her and this entire body. We come this evening to pray for your wisdom, for these our commissioners as they execute and enact the business for our county. We ask, oh God, that you would give them wisdom to make decisions that would be beneficial to not just a select few, but for the entire citizens of Clayton. And Lord, we pray your blessings upon our county. We believe that only your blessings and your favor upon us can help us to continue to prosper. Only your protection can keep us safe. We thank you for all of our law enforcement officials who are tasked with the responsibility of helping to protect us, and we ask that you would keep them safe as well. We pray, Father, for our leader, our chairman, Chairman Turner, that you continue to give him the wisdom and the discretion that he needs to lead us to greater and higher heights. May all things now be done in decency and in order, and that you would even be honored in this setting. It is in Jesus' name we ask and pray. Amen.
Amen. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening and welcome to the February 21st, 2017 regular business meeting. The first order of business is the adoption of the agenda. Does any member want to offer any amendments?
Yes, Madam Clerk, I have a couple. But ask that we remove Resolution 2017-13 dealing with the MARTA. Is there a second?
Second.
Probably move to second. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Also, ask that you remove under, I think it's Human Resources. Second here. Yes, Human Resources, item number five, the request to reconsider reclassification. Is there a second?
Second.
Second.
Probably moved in second. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. And lastly, I have a request for an emergency item to be added to the agenda from the Senior Services Department, and that is for an emergency request for food service operations, where we're asking that Piccadilly Restaurant provide temporary food services to the J. Charlie Griswell Senior Center and the Frank Bailey Senior Center on a temporary basis. Is there a second?
Second.
Probably moved in second. Those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed? It's unanimous.
Can we hold item number four as well?
Under what? Is that Human Services?
HR request number four for the solicitor?
Yes.
Second.
Probably moved in second. Those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed? It's unanimous.
Are there any further amendments? Hearing none, may we have a motion to adopt the agenda with the approved amendments?
I'll make the motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Probably moved in second. Those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed? It's unanimous.
Approval of the February 7, 2017 regular business meeting minutes.
Is there a motion? Is there a second? I'll second it. Properly moving second. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
The board has one proclamation to present this evening. Clayton County recognizes the Department of Parks and Recreation on receiving CAPRA accreditation as presented by Chairman Turner. Mr. Troy Hodges, as well as staff from the Parks and Recreation Department, you would please come forward as the commissioners come to join you for the presentation of the proclamation.
To set my hand and cause the seal of Clayton County, Georgia, to be affixed this 21st day of February in the year 2017, Jeffrey E. Turner, Chairman. The board will now consider the request of Director of Central Services, Carol Rogers.
And as Ms. Rogers is coming, I would like to just, Mr. Jesus is coming. Welcome to our meeting this evening, Mayor Willie Oswalt and Mayor Jeff Tatar from cities of Morrow and Lake City. Thank you for coming.
Council people from Morrow.
I can't see where they at. Oh, okay, Ms. Janelle Bridges is here as well. And who else? Where?
Councilwoman from Riverdale.
What did I miss? I didn't see everyone.
What's the lady name next to Janelle? Isn't she the manager?
No, it's the city manager. She's an elected official.
She's the councilwoman from Riverdale.
Who is? No, she ain't.
Okay.
I'm gonna sit next to Janelle. Let them go ahead and exit out before you start.
Oh, you need glasses.
Oh, Miss Cynthia Stamps Jones. That's who I was missing. How you doing? City of Riverdale. Okay, ma'am, you can proceed. If you would, take yours together unless a board member wants to single one out. Hearing none, please proceed.
Wait one second.
Hold on.
Yeah, the number one, if we can separate that one out.
Okay.
And anything else that's dealing with Epic.
Anything else dealing with what?
Epic Insurance Brokers.
One and ten?
Hold on a second. Give her a second.
Item number one.
Is that it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Take one. Go ahead and take one first and then group the rest together.
Okay. Good evening. I have 10 items. Well, let me start with this one. No, item number one.
10 items.
Okay. It's a total of 11.
Okay, well, we're going to take the first one.
First one.
10. Well, take the last 10 together.
Okay. Recommendation for renewal of county's crime policy for March 1, 2017 to March 1st, 2018. On July 5th, 2016, Epic Insurance Broker Consultants was awarded the contract for RFP 1632 to provide property and casualty insurance brokerage services to the county. Epic has presented the following proposals from Berkeley Regional Insurance Company, located in Scottsdale, Arizona, for the renewal of the county's crime insurance coverage, and Western Surety Company, located in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, for the statutory position bond renewal for the policy period from March 1st, 2017 to March 1st, 2018. The crime policy protect the county from losses due to employment theft, employee dishonesty, robbery, computer fraud, forgery, or alteration, funds transfer, and other criminal acts. Epic has provided a proposal from our incumbent carrier, Berkeley Regional Insurance Company, that includes a level premium for the crime insurance coverage. The total premium will be $9,960, the same as the current year. Funding is available through the county's general fund, fiscal year ending 2017.
Okay.
All right, is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second? Probably moved and second. Any questions?
I have a question.
Commissioner
this
Warner.
Is the same company that also does our health insurance and all our insurance, correct?
Epic Insurance?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Are we receiving some type of a discount for having all of our insurance through them? Just wondering how are they awarded every contract that we have?
They went through the RFP process, and it went through the process with the selection committee.
And so they went, they were vetted through the regular RFP process.
Is it the same selection committee for all of the?
No, ma'am.
It was different selection committees? Okay.
Any other questions? Hearing none, those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Nay.
It's 4-1, it passes. Commissioner Warner opposed.
Before I continue with the other items, I would like to point out that, or advise the board that there is a change on item number 8 for the BOC memo for Project 1642. And you should have a copy of the revised BOC memo. We revised the memo to include the product update and implementation support for years 1 through 5. And I will read that information when I reach number 8, but I want to make sure that you were aware of the change.
Okay.
Recommendation for renewal of annual contract RFP 1341, Telecommunications and Data Services annual contract. The recommendation is to renew the contract with AT&T Corporation located in Bedminster, New Jersey. The renewal period is from June 1st, 2017 through May 31st, 2018. There is 2 remaining renewals on this contract. The Board of Commissioners approved the award on May 6, 2014. The department and vendor renewal acceptance and the amendment to the agreement for the above reference project has been attached for your renewal, for your review and information. Next, recommendation for renewal of annual contract RFP 1407, Auditing Services for Clayton County, Georgia, also annual contract. The recommendation is to renew the contract with Maldlin and Jenkins, LLC, located in Macon, Georgia. The renewal period is from June 1st, 2017 through May 31st, 2018. There are no remaining renewals on this contract. The Board of Commissioners approved the award on April 15, 2014. The department and vendor renewal acceptance and the amendment to the agreement for the above reference project has been attached for your review and information. Next, recommendation for name change for RFP 1691, Comprehensive Transportation Plan Update for Clayton County, Georgia. The recommendation is to change the name and address of the awarded vendor for RFP 1691. Central Services received notification that the official legal name of their company is Parson Brankenhoff, Inc., and that the principal place of business is located on 1 Penn Plaza, New York, New York. This award was approved by the Clayton County Board of Commissioners during regular business meeting on January 3rd, 2017. The contract has not been executed. Clarification form W-9, and the revised agreement are attached for your review and information. Recommendation for approval to utilize National Joint Powers Alliance cooperative contract with Mohawk Carpet Distributors, Inc. for countywide carpet and flooring supply installation. The recommendation is to utilize National Joint Powers Alliance co-op contract with Mohawk Carpet Distributors, Inc., located in Culham, Georgia, for countywide carpet and flooring supplies and installation. Funding is available through various department budget. The National Joint Powers Alliance contract is attached for your review and information. Next, recommendation for approval to utilize National IPA TCPN cooperative contract with Train US, Inc., for 911 call center Lindbergh replacement. The recommendation is to utilize National IPA cooperative contract with Train US, Inc., located in Davidson, North Carolina, for 911 call center Lindbergh replacement in the amount of $50,595. Funding is available through 2015 SPLOS funding. The department recommendation National IPA Renewal Award Letter is attached for your review and information. Next, request for first contract amendment for RFP 1517, police body cameras for Clayton County, Georgia. This request is to amend the current contract with Utility Associates, Inc., located in Decatur, Georgia, to include video storage for in-car cameras for Clayton County police vehicles. The request is for a total of $280,800 for 3 years of unlimited video storage. The Board of Commissioners approved the award on April 5th, 2016. Funding is available through the general funds. The department acceptance, the amendment, and vendor quote are attached for your review and information. The revised memo is the next one for recommendation for award, RFP 1642, Enterprise Resource Planning, ERP, System for Clayton County, Georgia. The recommendation for award is for the most responsive and responsible proponent meeting the specification with the exclusion of the tax keeping management and fleet management solutions with the highest score to Tyler Technology, Inc., located in Yarmouth, Maine, in the amount of $7,726,396.10, with a not-to-exceed travel amount of $564,420. Funding is available through the 2015 SPLAS funds. The evaluation tabulation summary, department recommendation and agreement are attached for your review and information. Next, item seven, project number 1739, request to sell county surplus property and equipment. Central Services is requesting the necessary approval from the Board of Commissioners to sell surplus county property and vehicles at absolute auction. The list of surplus property and equipment is attached hereto as Exhibit A, and the list of surplus vehicles is attached hereto as Exhibit B. Next, recommendation for renewal of Clayton of County's public official position statutory bond renewal for March 1st, 2017 to March 1st, 2018. On July 5th, 2016, Epic Insurance Broker Consultant was awarded the contract for RFP 1632 to provide property and casualty insurance brokerage services to the county. Epic has presented the following proposals from Western Surety Company, located in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, for the statutory position bond renewal for the policy period of March 1, 2017 to March 1st, 2018. The public official position statutory bond provides coverage for all county public officials required by the state statute or county code to carry a surety bond. Epic has provided a proposal form for our incumbent courier, Western Surety Company, in the amount of $11,753 for the public official position statutory bond. This is an increase of $173 over the current premium. Funding is available through the county's general fund fiscal year ending 2017. Next, emergency request for food service operations for the Clayton County Senior Services Department. The recommendation is to approve an emergency temporary agreement for food services operation at the J. Charlie Griswold Senior Center and the Frank Bailey Senior Center with Piccadilly Food Services LLC, located in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. The emergency temporary agreement is necessary to provide food services to the seniors and citizens of Clayton County. Funding is available through the county's general fund. The department's recommendation, vendor fee form, and emergency temporary agreement are attached for your review and information. This request is for you to approve the recommendations, authorize the chairman or his designee to execute all necessary documents to accomplish the intent of the contracts and authorize the Chief Financial Officer to amend the budget accordingly. I'm sorry. For the record, I would like to correct number 8, where I said excluding tax keeping, it should be timekeeping. Apologize. We're excluding timekeeping management.
Okay, thank you. Is there a motion? I'll make the motion. Is there a second?
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Are there any questions on any of the items?
I do. On the emergency agenda item, it says, because we just got this, there's a management fee plus documented losses. Maybe I didn't see it, but what are the documented losses defined as?
For the food service operations?
Yes. I mean, everything else is self-explanatory, but the losses per month.
Strader.
The documented losses, I'm sorry, good evening.
Good evening.
The documented losses is we have a projected revenue amount that we expect for the cafeterias for both years, mm-hmm. and the $53,000 that's in the document is the loss that is projected over the next year to operate both cafeterias.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Thank you. This is for 6 months. Is it 6 months or 3 months?
Actually, the temporary agreement is 90 days until we can get to agreement.
Any other questions? Hearing none.
On that, hold on. On that or on something else?
On anything.
Okay, I don't have a question, but I do have a correction.
Ms.
Not you. Yeah.
Thank you, Ms. Strong.
Under number 8.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the amount, the not to exceed travel amount. You read into record $564,420. It should be $440.
For the record.
For the record, yes.
564,440.
Yes.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Statements, comments? Hearing none. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Thank you.
The board will consider requests of Chief Financial Officer Ramona Bivens.
Please take yours together.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Vice Chair, Commissioners. I have 3 items for your consideration this evening. Budget Amendment 2-15 is for probate court to provide funding for the probate court paralegal approved at the February 7th, 2017 Board of Commissioners meeting in the amount of $32,283. Budget Amendment 4-106 is for 2004 SPLOST to appropriate funds from the SPLOST fund balance in the amount of $10 million for right-of-way acquisitions for Mount Zion Boulevard and Battle Creek Road. Budget Amendment 4-107 is for 2009 SPLOST to appropriate funds from the SPLOST fund balance in the amount of $4 million for Valley Hill Road bridge construction and Brown Road bridge design construction.
All right, do we have a motion?
So moved.
There a second?
A second.
Any question on any of the items? Hearing none. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
Thank you.
The board will consider requests of Human Resources Director Pamela Ambles.
Good afternoon.
Good evening, Chairman, Vice Chair, and members of the Commission. Human Resources, we have 6 items for your consideration this
evening.
Please
take them together. I'm sorry, Sam.
Take them together?
Yes.
Okay. If I'm going to take them together, I would like to recognize the fact that Mr. Chris Clark, as well as Ms. Chloe Gentry, did I get your name correct, Chloe, from EPIC, they are here on Human Resources' behalf this afternoon.
Yeah, we can take all the benefits separate, and because we need to take this
what
separate.
What item number do you want to take separate?
That's why I was trying to turn on and started talking. Sorry about that. It would be item number 7, 8. Anything dealing with the broker services. And 6.
All right, and I would also like to let the board know that Mr. Chris Clark, he postponed a cruise in order to be here tonight. He told me not to say that, but I'm going to say
it anyway.
I
could give him credit, but he's got all of our business.
All right, take them all together except for 6, 7, and 8.
Okay.
Take those separately.
Thank you. In collaboration with impacted departments, We are requesting an amendment to Civil Service Rule 7.301, which will extend the probationary period from 12 months to 18 months for the positions of Deputy Sheriff 1, Sheriff Correction Officer, Sheriff Correction Officer 1, and Police Officer 1. Let me make sure that I have those positions all listed. Deputy Sheriff 1, Sheriff Correction Officer, Correction Officer 1, and Police Officer 1. Employees holding these positions must successfully complete mandated training in order to be able to hold those positions. Delays in training, as well as unsuccessful first attempts, often prompts the departments to go before the Civil Service Board to extend the probationary period for these employees. Back in 2006, the rule was amended to extend the probationary period for our Firefighters 1, who is now known as Firefighter Recruits. So what this rule will do, this amendment will do, is it will put the likewise positions all in the same probationary category of 18 months. We're also requesting the Board of Commissioners to enter into a consignment agreement with Six Flags Over Georgia and Whitewater for the purpose of providing discounted tickets to our employees. This is a program that we have had in place for a long time and it has worked very well. We're also requesting the Board of Commissioners to enter into a consignment agreement for discounted online ticket purchases with Zoo Atlanta for our employees. This is the first time that we are able to make this request, and we are looking forward to the board's consideration and being able to offer this to our employees. And that's the last one before I get into the renewals.
Okay, do we have a motion? I'll make the motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Properly moved and seconded by Commissioner Hambrick. Are there any questions on any of the items? Hearing none, those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
Human Resources is seeking approval from the Board of Commissioners to renew our group short-term disability coverage with the Hartford for Clayton County employees. The renewal includes a 3-year rate guarantee. This plan year, we're pleased to offer 3 coverage options for our employees. We're offering a 7-day waiting period, a 14-day waiting period, and we are maintaining the current 30-day waiting period. Employees can select 50 to 60% of his or of their salary, and employees paid a premium for this coverage, therefore there is no budgetary impact to the county.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second? Second. Any questions?
Question, do they have to use all of their sick leave first?
From my understanding, Commissioner Warner, they do not. That we are able to prorate that. I will ask Chris, I'm gonna take advantage of my resources that are here, if I can get Chris to come up, and he'll be glad to answer any technical questions such as the look back period, the elimination period, and so forth.
Okay. State your full name for me and the company you work for.
It's Christopher Clark with Epic Insurance Brokers.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, the question was, do you require, or does the plan require the employees to use all of their sick days prior to utilizing the benefit they pay for?
No, they won't have to use their sick days. They can choose to use them or to get the benefit.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you. Next.
Human Resources is also seeking approval from the Board of Commissioners to renew our long-term disability coverage. The renewal includes a 3-year rate guarantee, and we are renewing with the Hartford. The employee will not experience a rate change or coverage change. Once again, employees pay for this benefit, therefore there is no budgetary impact to the county.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
A second.
Any questions?
I'm good on that.
Hearing none, those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Next.
The last one, Human Resources is seeking approval to renew our group life insurance coverage with the Hartford for Clayton County employees and retirees. The county currently contributes 76% of the premium for the basic life coverage. Employees cover the entire cost of any supplemental or voluntary coverage for themselves, their spouse, or their dependents. This renewal offers a 3-year rate guarantee, and there are no change to coverage levels, and there is no additional cost to the county.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second?
A second.
Probably moved and second. Any questions?
None.
That's it?
I didn't get a vote yet.
Okay.
Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Thank you.
Thank you all. We appreciate it. And thank you, Chris.
Interim Chief Staff Attorney Jack Hancock.
Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I have one ordinance, two resolutions, and four department requests for your consideration.
Take them together unless somebody wants to single one out. Here are none.
Ordinance 2017-12, an ordinance to amend the Code of Clayton County, Georgia, is amended specifically to amend Part 1, Chapter 22, Businesses, Article 2, Occupational Licenses, Division 1, generally Section 2234, Revocation, Subsection A, Calls for Revocation to repeal conflicting laws, ordinances, and resolutions to provide for severability, to provide for an effective date of the ordinance, and for other purposes. Resolution 2017-14 is a resolution authorizing the execution, delivery, and performance of an intergovernmental agreement with the Development Authority of Clayton County for the transfer of Lake City Crossing for economic development purposes, to authorize the chairman to execute all documents necessary to carry out the same, and otherwise to perform all acts necessary to accomplish the intent of this resolution, to authorize the chief financial officer to amend the budget where necessary to reflect an appropriate revenue source and expense, to provide an effective date of this resolution, and for other purposes. Resolution 2017-15 is a resolution authorizing the execution, delivery, and performance of a ground lease agreement with the Development Authority of Clayton County and Clayton Studios, LLC, for the development of a film and media studio complex for economic development purposes, to authorize the chairman to execute all documents necessary to carry out the same, and otherwise to perform all acts necessary to accomplish the intent of this resolution, to authorize the chief financial officer to amend the budget where necessary to reflect an appropriate revenue source and expense, to provide an effective date of this resolution, and for other purposes. Item 14 is a request by the Clayton County Library System that the Board of Commissioners apply for and, if awarded, enter into a grant award agreement with the Georgia Public Library Service Board of Regents of University System of Georgia through the Public Library Capital Outlay Grants Program, and accept grant funds for the building of the new Northwest Branch Library in College Park. The grant amount is $2 million. Although no matching contribution is required from the county has $6 million available from the county's 2009 SPLOS funds for the project. Further to authorize the chairman to execute the agreement and otherwise perform all acts necessary to accomplish the intent of the agreement, to authorize the chief financial officer to amend the budget where necessary to reflect an appropriate revenue source and expense, all as may be required under the terms of the agreement. Item 15 is a request from the Clayton County District Attorney's Office that the Board of Commissioners apply for and, if awarded, accept a grant award agreement, or excuse me, enter into a grant award agreement with the U.S. Department of Justice, Office of the Justice Programs, Bureau of Justice Assistance, and grant funds for the Smart Supervision, Reducing Prison Populations, Saving Money, and Creating Safer Communities Program. The grant is $750,000 over 3 years with no matching contribution required from the county. The grant would provide for the planning and implementation of a youthful offender accountability court to focus on first offender cases age 17 to 21. Further, to authorize the chairman to execute the agreement and otherwise perform all acts necessary to accomplish the intent of the agreement, to authorize the chief financial officer to amend the budget where necessary to reflect an appropriate revenue source and expense, all as may be required under the terms of the agreement. And in item 16, the Clayton County Parks and Recreation Department is requesting that the board approve the acceptance of a $1,000 grant from the Atlanta Falcons Youth Foundation for the procurement of football equipment for the athletics division of Clayton County Parks and Recreation. No matching funds are required. And finally, the Clayton County Department of Transportation and Development request the board to authorize the chairman to execute the Title V permit annual compliance certification for the landfill. The annual compliance certification is a condition of the landfill's Title V permit with the US EPA and the Georgia EPD. Title V permits govern air emissions regulations, testing, and reporting for the landfill. Mr. Chairman, I also advise the board that representatives of both the Development Authority and Clayton Studios LLC are present tonight.
Yeah. All right, is there a motion? I'll make the motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Properly moved and seconded by Commissioner Gregory. Are there any questions on any of the items? Hearing none, those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed? It's unanimous.
We do not need an executive session unless somebody on the board does.
No, we don't need one.
Okay, before. You going to call them up? No, they don't want to come. Yeah, we come. They don't want to say anything, though. But we will recognize them, though, and I appreciate that. Let me say this. I'm going to take a point of privilege to say that this studio project that was just approved was a long, 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 long time in the making. Finally got it accomplished and approved, and I appreciate the board for helping move this forward. Commissioner Gregory and myself have dealt with this company a long time.
Ms. Bivens.
And Ms. Bivens, that's right, that's right. I forgot about that. Was 2 years ago, though. Mm-hmm. At any rate, we have some executives from Pacifica Ventures in the back. I would like for Matt Ranchberg, I know I probably said your name wrong, but and Howard Mann to please stand. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you for being here. They flew in from California. Also, we have with us the privilege to have Lee Thomas, who is the State Film Commissioner with us. Where is she at? Stand up, Lee. Take your little, there you go. Thank you for the work that you put in to helping this become reality. Absolutely, thank you so much. And Larry Vincent with the Development Authority. Thank you, Larry, for you and the board for helping make this become reality as well.
And I want to know where the guy from Hartford was going on his cruise.
Miss Patrick.
Tamara Patrick.
Tamara.
Oh, yeah. How could we forget her? Because she stuck by this project through thick and thin.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the deputy over there. The deputy from
Bill. Bill. Bill where? Kerr, rather, I'm sorry, and Bill Kerr. Thank y'all for the work that you put in and the constant grind that you are on every day to make sure that we have quality films being filmed here in Clayton County. Let's get that on. And let's thank the legal staff while we're at it. All right. Thank y'all for redlining and tell Ms. Youngblood, thank you for the work that she's done. That
was so and we want to know where the Hartford representative was going on his cruise.
She's trying to get your tickets. All right.
I'm sorry, I'm going to hide under the podium, but your COO indicates that we need an executive session for a personnel matter.
See me after the executive session, CEO. Okay, so Madam Clerk, let's go to the next item, streetlight petitions. And unless the board oppose, I think it's streetlight.
It's
yes.
Streetlight.
I would like to take all the streetlights together unless there's a reason for us not to.
Man, a good
that's fine.
All
that's
right.
Good. That's item 18 through 21. The first is to accept a streetlight petition for Heatherwood Subdivision. The second is for Woodlawn Acres Subdivision. The next is for Dogwood Acres Subdivision. And the last is for Brookview Village Subdivision. Did we want to do separate motions or?
Oh, is that all of them? Okay.
That was all of them, Mr. Chairman.
No, you took them all together, right?
Motion to approve all of the streetlight petitions.
Second.
Right, like y'all in a hurry tonight. All right, probably moved in second. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
The next items are board appointments. The first is the appointment to the Department of Behavioral Health and Developmental Disabilities Region 3 Advisory Council. This is to fill the unexpired term of Dr. Angelita Howard, who has resigned. The term expires on February 28, 2018. This is a full board appointment. Are there any nominations? Hearing none, the next two are to the Solid Waste Management Authority. The first is to fill the expired term of Andrew Love. The term is 4 years, expiring on December 31st, 2020. This is a full board appointment. Are there any nominations?
I'm comfortable making the motion to reapprove Mr. Love.
I'll second it. Properly moved and second. Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
I'd like to ask that we hold the other appointment, the vacancy.
Okay. We'll hold the next solid.
Did anybody have a nomination?
This is for a solid waste authority.
Yes. Did anybody have somebody you wanted to appoint? All right.
And that was just for the solid waste?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
Vice Chair, was that just for the solid, the next solid waste?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Okay.
Seeing how nobody,
item number 25.
Hold on, Madam Clerk.
I'm sorry.
Seeing how nobody else had a nomination, then yes, we'll hold.
Thank
next.
You.
Okay. Item number 25 is the appointment to the Veterans Advisory Board, and that's to fill the unexpired term of Evan Black. The term expires on June 6, 2018. Chairman Turner, this is your appointment.
Ask the board to appoint Leonard Morgan. Is there a second?
Second. Leonard Moreland?
Leonard Morgan.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Is there a second?
A second.
Probably moved and second. Those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed? It's unanimous.
And the next appointment is to the Veterans Advisory Board to fill the unexpired term of Diane Hanna. The term expires on June 6, 2018. Chairman Turner, this is also your appointment.
All right. Okay, let's just hold that till next meeting. Excuse me, I don't need that.
Okay. We have one zoning petition. The applicant is Jennifer Mastronardi and Phil Herron. The request is for a rezoning from a state residential district to agricultural district. This is for property located at 11599 Turner Road. This is in Hampton, Georgia. This is Commission District 3, Commissioner Warner.
I make a motion that we approve the recommendation of the board.
Hold on a second. We have got to go through the process first. Is the applicant here? Please come to the podium.
Do we have anyone that wants to speak in opposition? Is there anyone that wants to speak in opposition to the petition? Anyone that wants to speak in opposition to the petition? Thank you.
All right. For the record, how about stating your name and
Good evening, board. I'm Phil Herron.
Excuse me.
Mr. Mastronardi cannot be here tonight.
Well, he needs to state his name for the record first, all right? Go ahead, sir.
Ms. Mastronardi cannot be here tonight to join me. She had a baby 2 weeks ago.
Oh, congratulations.
All right, madam.
I'm sorry, did you give your name?
Yes, Phil Herron.
Phil Herron.
You got a motion.
Okay, I make a motion that we accept the approval of the board.
Second.
All right, properly moved and second. Any questions?
Or is it going to be open to the public or is it going to be private?
Sir, that question was for you.
Oh, you have questions for me?
It's okay. Look, I understand. You got a new baby. We're good. We're good.
Everything good?
I have a question, just a technical question. It's not even more for you. It's more maybe for you. The proposed zoning is for agricultural, and the proposed use is for conservation residential. Does that mean, am I reading that right? Did I not see that right? I was just wondering if there was some sort of watershed problem or something on there that gave some sort of square footage density.
No, sir. The application request is for the property to be rezoned from a state residential down zone to agriculture for the purpose to use for a horse farm and
right.
to build a barn.
Right.
I'm sorry, Ms. Smith. Could you please just state your name for the record?
My name is Kimberly Smith, the Planning and Zoning Administrator for Clayton County.
And I actually visited the area along with...
No, I get that. It just says right here on page one, it says proposed zoning, agriculture, proposed use, conservation residential.
Mm. So that must be a misprint. Mm. Is that in the staff report?
It's under staff report, yes. Under zoning and land use. Current land use, proposed land use.
Okay.
on page one of the
Yes, that's incorrect.
Okay.
Okay.
So we need to correct that first.
I think I would recommend, if you're open to ideas, taking a recommendation from Ms. Smith, and if that's acceptable by the petitioner, then amending your motion to approve with the correction.
If we can, amend my motion to approve with the correction, so that would be.
For the record, Ms. Smith, state the correction.
One moment, please.
Now I can ask you the question, I guess. Is the horse farm open to the public, or is it going to be private?
No, it's open to the public.
Wonderful.
Plan on riding, Commissioner?
All right. There are four children. They want to ride.
Not only for kids.
I'm sorry?
Not only for kids, neither.
Not only for kids.
The proposed land use is for agriculture and livestock. On parcels greater than 3 acres, and all acres for animals must be enclosed by fencing. So it's basically for agriculture purposes.
All right.
Ms. Warner, would you mind if I made an amendment to your recommendation to approve to include an amendment for agricultural use, not conservation residential?
No, I wouldn't.
So moved.
Second. Probably moved in second. Any other questions? Hearing none. Those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed. It's unanimous. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. On the original motion, is there a second on the original motion? You made the motion.
Yeah.
Is there
a
second?
And I second the original.
Yes, Commissioner.
Those in favor? Those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this concludes this evening's agenda. If there is no further business to discuss, we did have a request to go into executive session on personnel matters.
And before I make that motion, I also failed to point out earlier that the two mayors, Jeff Tatar and Willie Oswald, were instrumental in helping get the studio and some of the rezoning and other ordinances in place to make it happen. So thank you both for being here today. All right, motion to go into executive session.
So moved.
I'll second it. Those in favor, aye.
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 Opposed? It's unanimous. Motion to reconvene.
So moved.
Second.
Probably moving second. Those in favor, aye.
All right.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
All right.